Hi, I'm Mike Schneider, a Texas Instruments MSP Systems and Applications Engineer working on the metering solutions using ultrasonic technology. Today I will discuss the basics of how to use the new Ultrasonic Design Center for water flow measurements. The Ultrasonic Design Center GUI provides a seamless, out-of-the-box experience for the MSP430FR6047, our ultra-low power microcontroller for high-precision ultrasonic sensing. The GUI allows developers to quickly begin making experimental water flow measurements. To get started, you will need the EVM430FR6047 evaluation module, a flow pipe with two transducers, and the Design Center software. After installing the Design Center GUI, connect the EVM to the computer and launch the GUI application. Connect to the EVM by clicking on the Connect option under the Communications drop-down menu. Once connected, configure key parameters that the firmware will use to update the library configuration. Modifying these parameters allows developers to customize the ultrasonic measurements and behavior of their application without changing the firmware. Helpful information can be seen by hovering over the parameter. Additional descriptions for these parameters can be found in the Ultrasonic Sensing Design Center User's Guide. The F1 excitation frequency is the frequency of the transmitted output pulse and is mostly dependent upon the transducer's operating frequency. This value can be optimized using the GUI's frequency sweep functionality I will demonstrate later in this video. For now, I will use 1020 kHz. I will set the number of excitation pulses to 20 for each measurement. This parameter is dependent upon the pipe being used, power consumption, and performance requirements. The UPS and DNS gap is the time between upstream pulse and downstream pulse. This parameter is also dependent upon the pipe being used, power consumption, and performance requirements. The UPS 0 to UPS 1 gap is the time between the start of two consecutive measurements, essentially the measurement rate. I will set this to 100 milliseconds, equivalent to 10 Hz. In addition, I set the gap between the pulse start and ADC capture, the GUI-based gain control, and meter constant to optimal values for a specific pipe. There are some additional parameters in the Advanced Parameters tab. These include ADC sampling frequency, signal sampling frequency, capture duration, ultrasonic crystal settling time, and others. Now that the configuration is complete, save the configuration using Save Configuration. The configuration file can be loaded at a later point with Load Configuration. Request Update will send the configuration to the device. Now we are ready to take measurements. To view a single capture, go to the ADC Capture panel and click Capture. The ADC Capture graph should display a single ADC capture. This is an important first step to verify the integrity of the signal. Developers can readjust the parameters to obtain the desired response for their system. By right-clicking on any of the plots and graphs in the Design Center GUI, we can capture the image with the Capture Screen option. To log data that is captured by the GUI, navigate to the Options menu. Click on the Logging option, set the location, and check the checkbox to automatically log data. Press OK. To begin capturing the waveform data, navigate to the Waveforms panel and click Start. The waveforms for absolute time of flight, delta time of flight, and flow rate should begin to appear graphically, and the data will be logged into a CSV file. There are statistics displayed below the delta time of flight and flow rate graphs. By right-clicking on any of the three plots, users can use the graph options to edit the bounds on the three plots, choose what length of time they want to display the data over, and choose how many samples of data are used to calculate the statistics. The frequency sweep panel will plot the peak amplitude of up to 26 consecutive captures in reference to their transmit frequencies. The consecutive captures will start at the frequency of the F1 parameter and increment 12.5 kHz each capture. I'm going to set the F1 parameter to 950 kHz, then set the number of captures to 9 and click the frequency sweep button. We see the plot of the peak amplitudes of each of these 9 consecutive captures. The frequency displayed with the max peak amplitude is recommended to use for the F1 parameter, since this generates the best response from the tested transducer. For more information on the MSP430FR6047, the EVM, and the Ultrasonic Sensing Design Center GUI, visit the links shown. Thanks for watching.